In this video we will talk about crossbreeding Pattedale Terriers, and we will focus on three areas: functionality, especially within the group of Fell Terriers, so Hunting Terriers crosses. Then we will focus on other functional crosses, especially with the Bull Terrier types, and also some of the running dogs. And the third would be improving other breeds by adding Pattedale Terrier blood to invigorate those existing breeds that are on the downhill. So please stay ready and we will start now. Today we want to talk about crossbreeding Pattedale Terriers with other breeds. So first, to start with the Pattedale Terrier. Pattedale Terrier is a working breed and it is not uncommon to be interbred with other species within the Fell Terrier group, because Pattedale is an example of a Fell Terrier. Most think it's the most evolved Fell Terrier of all, and so a specific version of the Black Fell Terrier. This is not stating that all Pattedales are black, but these dogs were once developed as black dogs, and still most are. And that's a good thing as well, because the black coat helps to reduce heat in the body of the dog, because it is the best color to get the heat out of the body. And especially because Pattedale is a terrier that works below underground, and it's a nice thing that you have a black coat, because you don't suffer from the heat from the sun underground, but you still have the benefit of being able to send out the heat of your body warmth as effective as possible. Okay, so as I mentioned, it's a part of the Black Fell Terriers, and it's quite common to be bred to other Fell Terriers, especially the black ones. Why do I state the black ones? Because there are also white Fell Terriers, and those white Fell Terriers, the most common examples are the Russells, so Jack Russells, Parson Russells, but also quite common lately, the Bull Russell, which is a serious alternative to the Black Fell Terrier, Pattedale Terrier, and doesn't get into that much damage as compared to Fell Terriers, Black Fell Terrier. And why? Because Russells often give more baying abilities, or more barking abilities. And that gives you less confrontation, so to say. So they use the barks to keep the quarry at its place. It's less effective than holding it, for example, that the Pattedale Terriers normally do. But still quite effective. So this could be an alternative that gives you less recuperation time for your dogs when they have engaged a formidable quarry. But you see this the rise of the Bull or Russell as well quite often now, but still the Pattedale is number one as an herd terrier. So that could be breeds that are interbred, but normally white and black Fell Terriers are not interbred. And why? Because the white are normally more the baying type, and the black are more the staying type, so to say. So a type that tries to grip and hold on. And they don't want to interchange those attributes, because otherwise you could be a jack of all trades but a king of none, and those two lines have been developed to be the best at what they do. So one is more baiting type of terrier, and still the white Fell Terriers are also quite confrontational, and the other one is the real confrontational type of bird terrier. Je ziet wel broer en zus hebben met die oortjes. Hoi! Ja, leuk hè? Goedemorgen.
Ja, inderdaad.
Zo, hoi hoi! So there were some Jack Russell crosses with other types of dogs, but those are from street dogs and not bred for a specific purpose. So it's a little bit different. But back on topic. Oh, we will wait a minute. Goedemorgen. Hey, lieve.
Goedemorgen.
Hey. Hallo.
Goedemorgen.
Lang geleden.
Zeker lang geleden, ja. Ik heb je geloof ik nog één keer gezien, toen zwaaide ik van de afstand, maar dat was het toch.
Oh ja. Hoe is het?
Goed hoor.
Ja,
goed zo. Dus ik zat nu iets dikker dan in de zomer, omdat ik wat meer vet wil hebben. Omdat ik iets meer vet heb in de winter, dus staat hij iets dikker.
Ja.
Hoi hoi. Hoi! En back on the topic. So these crosses, even within the white veld terrier range, should still be the veld terriers that they had. Another example of a veld terrier would be the German developed veld terrier out of English stock, which is the German Jacht terrier. It's also more of a baying type of dog and also more of a multi-purpose dog. So why the Whereas the white veld terriers are still earth terriers, the German Jacht terrier is a more of a jack of all trades because it's an earth terrier, but also very effective at chasing down, for example, wild hawks, good nose, and also more of a baying type of terrier. So not only grabbing, but also a lot of baying is there. A little bit of a mixed type. And also the veld terrier stood at his cradle. So that could be all the examples of what you could do, and then you could, for example, make your staying grip dog type of style, catch dog type of style, more of a mixed style, so including more baying, by interbreeding with those other veld terriers, other than black veld terriers. Another example that you could go to, and still keep it with it. Catchdog style is the Border Terrier, which is also a veld terrier, but a little bit smaller and also has a little bit shorter nose, but also very silent, strong dog type. Unfortunately, not the many Border Terriers are currently being worked, but it could also be a way to go. And you see this quite often still, the Border Terrier, Pattedale Terrier cross. Another cross one could do is working latent, and they state that Pattedale Terrier is like a working latent. It comes in different coat varieties, whereas the working latent is always the long-haired type, a rough coat, so to say, whereas Pattedale comes in three coats, broken, smooth as here, and also the longer coat. So these are all options to explore and still keep it in the veld terrier range. Of course, there can also be crosses outside the veld terrier range, and also a little bit within, and I will explain why. Also, in the start of making the veld terriers, they included some bull and terrier blocks, so to say. Goedemorgen. Hij is rustig. Oh jee, dan gaat hij ook weer. Hoi hoi. Zo, klaar, Spikey. So they included already some bull and terrier blood. It could be especially the bull and terrier of the heydays, which evolved into the Staffordshire Bull Terrier that we know now. The Staffordshire Bull Terrier are still working lines, especially the Irish Staffordshire Bull Terrier. And sometimes also modern evolution of the Bull and Terrier. It could be English, for example, English Bull Terrier. Goedemorgen. Especially the miniature, like they also did with the Bull Russells. It's often done to slow the Pattedale a little bit down. It's a confrontation style, get a little bit more baying in. So less damage. And also, they are crossing in the real absolute king of evolution in the Bull and Terrier breed, not evolution as into another species, but within the species this is the most evolved variety. American pit bull terriers are also often used to make crosses, for example, that are able to do a lot of the pit bull terrier work, but increase the hunting and drive by adding predator terriers. So, for example, better nose and also better skin and feet than the pit bull terrier has. Whereas the pit bull terrier brings a lot of qualities itself. Hey, goedemorgen. Hoop je daar beneden sluipen?
Gevaarlijke hond.
Ja, die zit sluipen bij elkaar, hè? Nee, hij niet. Hey, even langslopen.
Ja, we
spelen. Oh jee.
Ja, ze willen alle twee wel, maar wie begint? Aftasten. Ja, hetzelfde merk. Hebben
ja, hetzelfde merk, hetzelfde bouwjaar. Dat zal niet hetzelfde bouwjaar zijn.
Nee, die mij is 7.
Ja. Deze anderhalf.
Ja, daarom. Maar erg nieuwsgierig, natuurlijk.
Ja, dat hoort ook.
Hé!
Allebei jachthonden ook, hè?
Ja.
Hé, hey, dat is leuk.
Ja, wat is het?
Ja, ik weet niet veel.
Al een keertje. Hoi hoi.
Fijne dag.
So, for example, that is one of the crosses that do occur. So, for example, if you're hunting hogs, you get a lot more power by introducing pit bull terrier blood, of course. Also, sometimes for earth terriers, they introduce very small pit bull terrier bitches or diluted to 12.5% pit blood, and the rest all predator terrier blood to be able to fit in. This also occurs. Hence, for example, the hog hunting. Yeah, the stronger dog, this helps tremendously by your ability to hold and work the hog. Another cross that is sometimes done is to create a lurcher. So, for example, especially whippet. Predator cross is one to mention. So this gives you a lot of the speed of the whippet and a lot of the fighting ability. For example, if you're chasing down a fox in the open field, a whippet can chase down the fox, but cannot kill it, cannot hold it, cannot fight it. This is quite brittle, although being a lot bigger, because the Pattedale Terrier brings some qualities, and also because the feet of the Pattedale Terrier are quite strong, and also its coat is, that you have three coat varieties to choose from, you can also get better skin protection when you're bushing your dog, and also broader feet to distribute the forces a little bit more. So of course it will be slower than a purebred whippet, but still you get many benefits added to it by crossing a bit better the blood. So these are still all working crosses, and I think those are also not to be sneered at, in my opinion. And then we go to the last category, which is improving other breeds. So for example, some try to improve already white fell terriers. For example, some Russells that are losing their courage. If you infuse a small percentage of Pattedale Terrier blood, especially sometimes you also see that there's a throwback to white type of Pattedale, those are then used to revigorate the Russell strains. This is still working, but could be a little bit different, because you could already choose for the best strain, being a Pattedale, that's what you want. And also could be already covered between the crosses within the fell terrier group, as I mentioned earlier, but it's a phenomenon that we see. We also see this with the border terrier, so not just the cross, they want to have like 25% of Pattedale terrier blood to revigorate again the border terrier as a working terrier, which is also a great thing to do, for the border terrier. And could also lead in the long run to more outcross possibilities within the feral terrier group, so I also don't sneer at that. Still working in my opinion. And then you have the breeds that want to be improved by adding nose length or health, something like that. Crosses that you see here are, for example, the pug, Boston Terrier, French Bulldog. All those breeds have a very short nose. Also the Petit Brabançon, and they often breed them to Beagles, Shiba Inus, Jack Russell Terriers, something like that. But lately they found out, and also Staffordshire Bull Terriers, they found out that the Pratt Terrier is a lot smaller than most of them, and so more the size of the other dogs, and brings a lot more benefits health-wise, strength-wise, and also doesn't alter the shape of the breed that much. For example, the Puggle cross between the Pug and the Beagle gets a lot longer ears, which the Pattedale doesn't bring. And next to the nose length improvements, it also offers a longer back and other advances that are not to be sneered at, and a more healthy breed altogether, so you don't introduce a lot of health issues by breeding to a Pattedale Terrier. So that's a cross that you see lately. And same with, for example, Boston Terrier, especially because it already has the terrier bracket behind it. So it's a good way to introduce other terrier to increase nose length and health. And I think it's a lot better thing to introduce Pattedale Terrier than that what we did with the old Boston Bulldog. They increased the strength by introducing a lot of bulldog breeds, and that kept it with the same difficulties and the short nose length especially, and also increased the size tremendously. So for example, if you put an old English bulldog blood into your Boston Terriers, they will be almost twice as heavy. Yeah. So some of those examples are there. Petit Brabançon is like a pug, but then with a little bit different coat. And similar, also Affenpinscher is a breed that would be helped a lot with introducing the Pattedale Terrier blood. Affenpinscher is already very black. And also there are longer coat varieties of the Pattedale Terrier, which would surely complement it. And it would increase the nose length and also the health to a big extent. There are other crosses that are made, that are, for example, some people are crossing them to Labradors to get a little bit of the bravery back. Both black dogs and also both hunting dogs in the past. Whereas Labrador is a little bit phased out and the Pattedale Terrier is still there. So those crosses I've seen could be working. It could also be that they want to have a little bit lighter Labrador, as the Labrador lately has become quite heavy in many lines. Oh yeah, another cross that you see is in the Labrador example. Of course, all people know the Labradoodle, so the cross between Labrador and Poodle to create a specific breed. Also, poodles of small size are used to create small Labradoodles, but a Pattedale would be, of course, a better donor than just breeding to Poodle and Poodle again after the initial Labrador cross. And then you already start with a small scale, and they are better matched with small poodles and even medium poodles than Labradors are, and also a lot more healthy. They are of course a lot more driven as well, so it could be that you still don't get the temperament that you want, but if it's for the hypoallergenic properties, this could be at least as good of a try. And people are shifting to that direction as well, more of the desired dog breeds, so to say. Also crosses occur with other breeds, for example, sometimes spitz type of dog. Spitz type of dog is quite healthy dog as well. Although being more of a, yeah, such a primitive breed, so to say. And they are quite healthy. They're also living a long term. And they are often used, if they are used, to be very alert and to bark at intruders. But often a little bit, becoming a little bit cowardish. And then the Patterdale blood could help. Also, there are crosses within certain terrier breeds, for example, in the Netherlands, a Boer fox, that you want to have a dog that can take care of rodents and other intruders, pests, so like fox and other small predators, but can also guard the house. So it's not a dog that wants or needs to chase foxes down in their holes, but if the fox comes to visit, it would be nice that a dog would chase it and scare it off, or even if confronting it, kill it. And that's what they want. And these breeds are a little bit bigger than your average terrier. You also see this another example in Brazil, for example, the Brazilian terrier is also a little bit bigger, and they incorporate many terrier type of blood. Also an example could be the red terrier in the United States. And these breeds will be helped a lot by introducing Patterdale terrier blood, because they are still compact. They are very good dogs, not overly aggressive, but they will be there if the confrontation is there and to not back down. Another example that I didn't mention, which is still a working breed, they once created a specific strain, the Plummer Terrier, out of especially Jack Russell, with a little bit of Beagle blood, as an ultimate English type of red terrier. But they interbred, or inbred in this case, so heavily that they have many faults now in the breed. As you see that especially red Patterdale Terrier is introduced to get the breed stronger, better, and also more applicable for multiple purposes. So also giving it some of the Ur Terrier qualities that, for example, the Patterdale Terrier brings. And this could be like a variety, like the German Jacht Terrier, German Hunting Terrier. So more Jack of All Trade. And also as a red terrier, as a purebred, Patterdale Terriers are already very good at it as well. Also other terriers like Cilium, Danny Diamond, etc. can be revigorated with adding some Patterdale Terrier, other terrier hunting blocks. So I hope you liked this video, and if you do, please subscribe and let me know what you liked or disliked, if you liked the parts or you didn't. You can also place a comment to tell me what you really like. But please subscribe. Bye bye.